Testing. If you need a handheld, here it is.
All right. Well, I'll use this one for now. All right. Well, it looks like we didn't lose too many people after lunch. That's good. Thanks for coming back. So when I got a call from Mike, maybe less than 2 weeks ago, he said, do you mind filling in for one of the guys that's not going to be here? So, yeah, I'm not Michael Lemus. I said, sure. What's the topic? And he said, service excellence. And I thought, well, that's pretty apropos for our company because it's one of the ethos of our founder, Dana Garmany. So that's what I'm going to go over. I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the things that Troon does and some of the things that we do or should be doing in the industry to make sure we maintain our service excellence. Hold on, I got to put my glasses on. All right, service excellence, it comes in many forms, but we all know it when we experience it. I'll elaborate on this more in a minute, but first, I want to run through a quick video about our company. The main thing I want you to follow in this is just the prevailing theme that you see throughout this video.
Diverse, innovative, extraordinary. Three adjectives used to describe Troon, the global leader in golf and club management. What started at one course in 1990, today is more than 270 golf courses and six brands strong. Public, private or resort, stateside or international, quality and consistency define Troon and make our diverse list of managed properties extraordinary. Troon has evolved over nearly three decades, expanding beyond just golf. Today, we manage lodging units and operate fitness centers, marinas, equestrian centers, and 100-plus restaurants. Troon is now made up of six unique brands, all committed to delivering quality and consistency. Troon Golf represents a portfolio of daily fee, resort, and semi-private properties. Honors Golf includes extraordinary daily fee, resort, and private golf courses, all unified by the Honors trademark of exceptional quality and hospitality. Troon Privé oversees a portfolio of private clubs, making the clubs relevant, healthy, and sustainable for decades to come. Troon International's global footprint of world-class resorts, private and semi-private clubs, covers a broad spectrum of cultures and destinations. Caddy Master, the leading provider of caddy services in the world, managing over 2,000 caddies in 19 states and 3 countries. True Club Solutions, our newest division, specializes in one-time advisory services and extended consulting services in the golf and hospitality industries. At each Troon managed location, it's about more than just golf. It's about experiencing new places, creating lasting memories, and spending quality time with family and friends. And the innovative minds at Troon have developed programs and events to help us do just that. Families connect and bond through Troon Family Golf. Troon Rewards is the game's leading loyalty program with over 400,000 participants around the globe. Troon Cards help drive frequency of play at resorts and daily fee clubs. The Troon Privé Privilege Program and the Troon Advantage Programs provide members with exclusive access to other Privé private clubs and stunning destinations. Troon is dedicated to growing the game of golf in a big way. Troon Golf Academy offers unsurpassed golf instruction to help established players improve their games and bring new players to our clubs. The Troon Junior Club grows the game through fun instruction, exclusive events, course access, and cool gear for kids. The industry-leading Get Into Golf initiative provides all the tools necessary for new golfers to give golf a test run, including clubs, balls, instruction, and course time. And with the Troon Values Your Time Pace of Play program, rounds are faster and more enjoyable. While quality and consistency are words that define Troon, 12,000 associates over 38 states and 31 countries deliver the extraordinary to our guests every day, which allows Troon to excel and grow in the competitive world of golf, club, and hospitality operations. Here's to the next quarter century.
So the theme throughout that video was what? It was really the ambiance of service, relaxation, cleanliness, It's what we want our guests to feel like they're going to experience when they come to any of our facilities. Place where you're going to get away from when you getting away from home or from your work. Thank you. So that Dana Garmany is our chairman, has been our chairman since 1990. And really back then, Troon was the driving force behind rewiring an industry. Back then, I can't speak for all the Asian courses, I didn't know them back then, but certainly in the United States in 1990, if you were going to experience a great condition golf course and really a high quality of service and food and beverage, it wasn't going to happen at a resort course, and it wasn't going to happen at a daily fee course. It was generally at a private club. So Dana's idea was to take that model. Certainly, operating costs were going to go higher, but we were going to charge a little bit higher fee as well and bring that private club model to the daily fee. And that ethos shaped a culture that's seen us grow way beyond Dana's wildest imagination from back then to now become the largest golf management company in the world. I only show this slide. It's not something that most of us would be able to create something like this. Tenille Chu might at his 22 property golf facility at Mission Hills. But the point of this is putting information, you can put information for your associates, your staff, in a place where they can all access it, whether that's your standards, your SOPs, so that your managers are able to update it regularly and also have access to it quickly. That comes down to, and I'm going to get to it in a little bit, but the training and how your team responds to difficult situations. So service excellence, hospitality, it's all, they're both kind of synonymous terms, but hospitality is the halo that describes both great service and the service standards. And that's sort of the, everything starts with the standards that you set. And I apologize, some of this is going to be operational. I know a lot of you folks are at a higher level, but it's still important to understand because you need to be able to drive this down to the people that are running your facility. And I'll get to something later as to what you have for checks and balances to how do you know that these are happening or not. But so it starts with the standards. Then we go up to the service level, and then the broader ring is what people would refer to as the hospitality that you provide. So everybody needs standards, and your team needs to have a benchmark from where to start and understand what that daily baseline is, whether that's from the physical setup of the golf course to the way that they answer the phone to the way that consistency. You want consistency no matter what your brand is. And as I say, standards doesn't mean for a company like this, us, it doesn't mean having a cookie cutter approach or a hotel. Every Hyatt that you go to doesn't look the same, but there are certain touches that are similar. So you do want to have some standards that come across the board, but each facility should have its own personality and personal touches. And I'm going to give you a couple examples. These are not golf examples, but of some places that had some pretty interesting standards. There was a restaurant in Hawaii. I don't even know if it still exists, but in the 80s and 90s, it was one of the most famous places over there. It was called Longy's, just outside of Kapalua. And Longy's was, it was probably 100, 120 cover restaurant, so it wasn't small. They had 30 to 40 mains on their menu. It was extensive. And their shtick was no waiter could use paper or pencil. So everything was about, and this is way before technology. So I have no idea how they did it, but I was there once with a group of 10, ordered appetizers, ordered mains, ordered drinks. We were there 2.5 hours. Guy didn't miss anything, and we were trying to make him miss stuff. So somehow, now whether he had a microphone and there was a speaker in the back of the kitchen, but whatever it was, that was their shtick. That was their standard that everybody knew them for. Now I'm going to go the opposite example. There's a place some of you guys from the States might have been in. There's a place called Dick's Last Resort. Dick's Last Resort shtick is you go there to get abused. You go into the restaurant and the waiters are trained to be rude. They're not supposed to be obscene rude, but they're supposed to be funny rude. So that's their deal. So good service there is actually bad service, but it's in a funny way. So your service standards are all about what you set, but it's also what your customer ends up giving you the feedback. If you think you're doing something well, but your customer's telling you you're not, you're not. And like I said, there are thousands of standards that you can implement, but you want to focus on the very basics and then focus on what makes you unique. This is from the way your course is set up. Could be T marker width, pin flag type, fairway mowing patterns, how your practice facility is set up on a daily basis, how your golf cart stocked, card, folded or closed, pencil, golf tees, towels, where you park the carts for loading, do you have fresh cut flowers in the lobby, specific toiletries available in the locker room, do you do cold towels on the golf course, specific menu items in the restaurant. There are many, many standards that you can choose from, but you need to stick to yours and figure out which ones work. And standards exist across the board at every level, 365 days a year, at top quality properties. Another thing to keep in mind about, so we've talked about, and the facilities that we've seen are all very high end, which is great. But not every facility is created equally. You need to keep in mind, when you're setting standards for your facility, they're highly related to your overall strategy and what average rate you plan to achieve. You can't try to do all the bells and whistles, the singing and dancing, if you're going to charge a $50 green fee. So set standards that you're going to be able to maintain and afford to keep, at least for the short term. Look, we all know for the long term, we might start out at a certain level and markets change and things change. But in the short term, you need to stick to your opening strategy, and that strategy needs to tie into the financial side of it. With that, I want to training. Training is something, sorry, I was going to make the point that some standards do cost a lot of money, some standards cost zero. And the ones that you certainly, all of us can focus on are the ones that don't cost any money. And that comes down to the end guest experience and the people that are providing it. Tennille Chu mentioned earlier that the pyramid's upside down, and that is absolutely correct. You have more guest contact with the people, the guests have more contact with the people at the bottom than they necessarily do with the people at the top. So those people at the bottom need to be just as good as that guy at the top. And how do you do that? There's only one way, and that is training, training, training. It's critical in our business, but it's often something that we don't find time to do. Might do it once a year, and then, hey, okay, you're done. But it should never stop. Think about the unscripted situations that our people face almost every day, whether it's a guy coming in complaining about the slow play, or this golf cart stopped, or there was something on the menu. They have to know how to deal with those situations. And by if they practice it, they practice dealing with uncomfortable situations, they're going to be much, much better when they actually have to deal with the guest. This is just an example out of a Troon manual. I don't expect anybody to have stuff. This is one of probably 120 pages in the operations manual. Yours don't need to be this deep, but you certainly need to have standards that your team can go to. Okay? And next, you're also going to have, this is an example of an SOP set up for the practice facility. Again, same thing. Guys need to have SOPs so they know what the expectation is every day. Consistency, consistency. SOPs, though, they continue to change over time. If there's a situation that you that hasn't occurred before, medical emergency or something that you don't have it scripted, you're going to add that to your manual. How do we deal with this? So that your team knows. I kind of look at it like the decisions book in golf. Decisions book is constantly being updated because there's situations that arise that don't have a current ruling or a current situation. Same with your manuals. They need to keep updating. Okay, this was mentioned in the video. This was something that we started back in 2013 in conjunction with initiatives with the USGA. And this was putting a time par in place. I know we've all done stuff that relates to this in a certain way. We took it to a little bit of the next level by making sure it was in several places. They might see this five times before they get to the first tee. And the time par is based on your golf course. If it's a difficult golf course, it could be 4 hours and 45 minutes. If you're a private club that people get around quick, it might be 3 hours and 30 minutes. So it's very dependent on what your club and what the playability of your club is. But the fact that they've seen it in multiple places, it's in their head before they tee off. And it does. We have seen it make a significant difference. What is the bane of the golf industry is slow play. It is the number one complaint that we all get, especially resort courses. Private may not get the same level of complaints on that, but it's something that we're always trying to get better at. It's not easy, but I tell you what, if you have a golf course that's known for quick play, you're in a great place, because that is absolutely one of the something that you want to have a reputation for. This is just an example of what some of the clubs did when we first initiated it. This was in the summer at Abu Dhabi, so the guys wore t-shirts with the back with the time par on it. They put time par on the range balls. Another at the entrance of the... Thank you. Just more examples of what... But if you have one group in the morning, especially, again, I'm going to look at a daily fee resort situation. One group that takes 5 hours, they've just destroyed the day for 100 people that are playing behind them. So if you need to go out and upset that one group and tell them they need to get, you know, your course marshal or your player assistant, whatever you refer to them as, needs to get out there and make the move. They might be upset when they come off the golf course. Oh, he was badgering us. But you've just made 100 people behind them happy customers. Another thing that's critical for your team to be able to create excellent service is empowerment. If you do not have associates or staff at the lower level, oh, of course all your managers are empowered to make decisions, but if you can't get that down to the next level, then you're always going to get the, and we've all had it, you go into the restaurant, you got, oh, let me get my manager. That's really the last thing you want to hear. If it's something serious, you expect that. But just a normal complaint, let me get my manager? Come on, this person should be able to deal with that. And if they've been trained to that degree, plus if you've empowered them, maybe they come off the golf course, they had something happen to their golf cart, somebody hit into them, whatever. If your guest service guy was empowered to say, I apologize on behalf of our team, can I offer you a free drink, discount voucher on next round, discount voucher for F&B, something. How cool is that? That guy made an on-the-spot decision for that guest. Chances are, when he goes and writes his survey, you're going to get a pretty good mark, because it wasn't, let me get my manager, and it took 15 minutes to get a response. Yeah, there's always a risk of being taken advantage of when you do stuff like this, empower your people to do, but you've got to be able to trust them. This one, I'm just throwing this in as a last, this still is, we've all gone through training, we've all heard about how body language is an important aspect, but do we train it? And if I get a comment from someone, Muhammad Boyman comes off the golf course and he says to me, I had this, I had that, and I'm thinking, it was in my mind, like, oh, okay, and I look at him like that, right there he knows I didn't really give a damn. because I kind of looked up and said, in my mind, I'm thinking, that's a ridiculous question. But every customer has a right to be, he's the most important person at that time. And if your team can be trained to show that body language and not this and not, and deal with that person, again, that much better from the customer service perspective. And yes, there are, the point on this one was, there are culturally some differences. In Japan, for example, I lived in Japan for 4.5 years. And there you don't necessarily look people in the eye for very long. So I might not have that eye contact that I would in a more Western environment. But still, a smile and certain body language are universal. Those are, anywhere in the world, those work. Yeah, that's the right slide. Okay, next, technology. We've talked about technology. There have been several presentations on technology. And this is clearly where our business is going in the future. As I look around the room here, I see a lot of people who have been behind some of the great modern day developments. And some of you are using technology, some of you just happen to have, you know, you have great golf courses that people aspire to go play. But whatever it is that we're doing, we need to sustain, protect, progress our position as the leading leisure attraction and the preferred vehicle for developers in attracting visitors and property buyers, because that's what they are. Right now, golf is the thing that people look at. They want to sell property, they want to do, I want to build a golf course. That's great for us, but we need to make sure that is still at the forefront. And in order to continue us to, for golf to continue to move the needle, we're going to have to embrace technology, because it's here, it's coming, and it's going to come in a more important way. So I think some of the things that were talked about, John and Brian talked about the using the Pogo. How cool is that? We do the same thing, because, and especially in places where you have poor water quality, all of our clubs in the UAE now have purchased Pogo. They're not cheap. I think they're like $3,000, but it's well worth the money, because we have, again, bad water quality. Brian could be on a beach somewhere and know that his greens are still looking good in the from the statistics that he can get on his app from the Pogo. That is cool stuff. David Townend talked about the beacon technology. That is something that, again, if you have that on a laptop at the guest service place, they see who just drove in. I can walk up and say, "Hey, welcome to the club." Here, and they don't even know how I know their name. So there's some very cool stuff that's going to happen. Again, this is not so much at a private club. At a private club, you're expected to know who the members are. It's still nice to know where they are and when they left the property. But this is highly relevant to daily fee and resort courses. And technology can be used in a variety of ways. Some, as I said, help with productivity and efficiency in F&B. Some of them, like the bookings that we've talked about, help your front of the house team have more time to interact with guests, or faster checkout experiences. GPS in itself has changed the way, the expectations of what people have on a high-end golf course. I mean, again, in our region, I don't know what it is in Thailand, there's caddies, so you don't need it as much as what you do in other parts, but certainly in the Middle East region, almost every property now has a visage or some type of a system that allows the golfer to get yardages immediately. But there's a lot of other cool things that it does. It does scoring, and the back of the house things that it does in tracking is incredible. There's also, has anybody heard of the Shark Experience? I don't know if Greg's going to talk about it tomorrow, because Greg Norman is the creator of it. The Shark Experience is taking GPS technology. He's done a partnership with GPSI and Club Car. And I know you purists might cringe a little bit, but this is this is the GPS experience, but there's music. There's streaming music into here. There's streaming sports, if you want to see sports ticker, that are in there. So it's a full immersion experience while you're on the golf course. Again, for purists, maybe that's not important, but I tell you what, up-and-coming golfers, the millennials, that's what they want. So we're going to have to, it's not for every private club, I'm not saying that, but as a whole overall industry, we have to embrace this stuff. The other thing that I think is important for all of our facilities, public or private, is we all have access to social media. And whether it's Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, video has become the king of content on that stuff. That's what people want to look at. So I urge you all, if you don't have now, just to create an ambiance video. Put it on your website. Put it on your some other social media outlets that you have, and see the impact that it has on. Again, for private clubs, not as critical, but it also helps to attract members. So here in the next slide, I'm going to give you an example. This thing was done for less than $1,500 by the Elks Club in Dubai. Again, that's trying to show the entire ambiance of the club. Unfortunately, right now, there's no fitness center or pool that is coming, or that would have also been a part of that. So you can do that nowadays with cheap cameras and get a very good product and showcase your facilities with all the cool things that you have. Believe me, you all have very cool things to show. Get it out there. Okay, then the last bit that I want to go to with technology is the booking. And Golf Citizen was a perfect thing to show earlier because I think that is fantastic, especially for clubs that are individual clubs that may not have the resources to create something like that we did with the Troon International app, although we'll still use Golf Citizen as well. We'll try to be in as many places as we can. But absolutely, having people on their phone being able to book in 5 clicks in 45 seconds is a game changer. For us, It came, we still do have easy links, but quite frankly, their system is not very quick. It's a bit antiquated when you got to book online through that. So we created an API access through it, but now with this app, it's all you're seeing is the app experience. We treat it like Uber. In order to book, you have to have your credit card on file. And yes, again, that was one of the paradigms in the golf industry. Nobody wants to leave their credit card. Oh, they won't do it. Well, they will do it. If that's their only option, believe me, they do it in a lot of other industries. Uber's doing quite well, and that's the way they've been doing it for 5 years. So once the consumer has the trust, they know their credit card's in a safe place, they actually like it. It's way easier. All they're doing is booking, done. It's paid, but they still have the ability to cancel that tee time within 48 hours. And imagine for you guys, I don't know how many of you don't track your no-show charges. Private clubs, again, different story. But for daily fee and resort, we had one facility that had over $250,000 in no-shows that they couldn't recover. That's huge over time. So the other thing with the EasyLinks, I'm going to get to it on the next slide. Is guest feedback. That is our most critical, I think our most critical tool, and all of you as well. We can think we're giving great service and we think we're doing the right thing, but if our guests don't agree with that, then we need to change tact in some ways. So what we've used EasyLinks for in the past, we're going to change at the end of this year, and I'm going to show you a few slides of this other company. But every time the golfer finished, as long as you had good data going in, email went out. And because it was, again, on their mobile phone, people would tend to do it. We saw the response rate go up by at least 5 times versus the paper. The other thing with paper, staff can stuff the ballot box. So this way, you eliminate that, right? You're getting true data. And if people had a negative response, we could trigger that to go straight to our office too. So we could see it immediately. And the fact that that customer would get a response from Steven as the GM, they're blown away. They just don't get responses from GMs. They usually get sort of a canned response or something else. So that kind of customer service really, again, elevates you to the next level. So this is an example of what an email that you would get back after your round. You click the link and then it takes you to the survey, which is relatively simple. It also allows the facilities to track each other because they compete against each other as to how they're doing in their own in their ratings. Okay, this last bit is I'm going to go through this just really quick. I'm not even going to talk about it. This is something, and I don't know that much about it yet, but it's called Players First. It is a guest satisfaction survey tool. Troon is moving to, we don't have anything to do with it. We don't own it. It's just something that we've looked at and we think it's pretty cool. So as of next year, we're rolling over to it. Something anybody can have access to with Players First. But what they do is guest satisfaction to a much higher level. They track a lot of different statistics and they keep it in a database that's very easy to track. So these are, you've all heard of net promoters, which is what most people now say is the key for your, you want people that are walking away from your facility and saying they're a promoter, right? So they're the most valuable customers. So these are some of the things that this technology will do for you. That's when you get to the email part. If you want to close the loop, some graphs that it can direct, and that's the dashboard, the ultimate dashboard. Oh wait, I'm changing it on here, and you're not seeing it. Sorry. So net promoters. And then you can also compare yourself year over year. March last year I was here, March this year, why are we down? And that's the email. And then the dashboard example of all the things that this tracks. So very interesting. I haven't used it yet, but I think it's something that is... So in summary, we need to commit to standards. You need to make sure you're pushing it down with your teams on the ground so that they can deliver, and then training. Training. At the end of the day, what you want to be is different, above the competition. Things that you do for service. I'm going to close with two examples of great service experiences that are way above and beyond. We had a guy at a club waiting for a taxi, because it was a new place. It wasn't that easy to get to. Waiting for a taxi, 20 minutes, 6 o'clock at night. He needs to get to a meeting in Dubai. He's getting frustrated. He could see it. Our guys were almost done for the night. Our guest service guy offered to drive 40 minutes to Dubai to his hotel. Now, the guy didn't live in Dubai. He had to drive all the way back. But that blew this guy away that we were willing to do that. Another one, we've got a retail manager at one of our private clubs. There's a couple members that love certain product. Every time it comes in, the new lines come in, she'll take it, hang it in their lockers. It's up to them. If they want it, she'll put it on their tab. If they don't want it, they bring it back to the golf shop. So those are little things that your teams can do to raise the bar, okay? But our industry is known for service. Let's keep it there. Do the things that we need to do to be the best, okay? Thank you very much.